So hi everyone and welcome to this second masterclass which is going to be on antagonist protocol or the short protocol. Now as we all know, all this is basically done in order to prevent a premature LH surge. We've all studied this, right? In the previous episode, we discussed about the agonist. What does the agonist do? Agonist causes downregulation of the receptors. But what does antagonist do? A GnRH antagonist is going to go and straight bind to the receptor. Alright, so because it binds to the receptor, it is very quick, it is immediate, and it is reversible. All the three things. It is quick, it is immediate action, and it is very rapidly reversible. So now because of these advantages which it offers, it has become the protocol of choice, especially when somebody wants to do a individualized controlled ovarian stimulation. This protocol is extremely simple. The patient is called for an initial assessment either on the first or the second or the third day of the menses. When that happens, obviously you are going to look at the antral follicle count. Along with the antral follicle count, you are simultaneously also going to assess the estradiol levels if you have the facility to do that, and you are going to rule out any formation of a cyst. Remember, if at all there is a cyst, you can just safely aspirate the cyst. Okay, and in such situations, you can also give something called as a pre-treatment antagonist. Okay, you can give a pre-treatment antagonist if you find it to be beneficial. We use a pre-treatment antagonist on the first day, second day, and third day for almost all the patients, irrespective of their hormonal parameters. There is one thing which you should understand as far as the ovary is concerned. The recruitment of the follicles is actually going to begin in the previous cycle. So when the patient comes to you on the first day or the second day or the third day, the picture inside could be something like this. All the follicles could be of varied sizes. Okay. All these follicles could be of varied sizes. Now, because they are of varied sizes and because they've already been recruited, what is going to happen in a situation, especially when you are using antagonist, is the follicles are going to grow slightly different to each other. Some follicles could be 12, 13, 14 millimeters, some could be 7, some could be 9, some could be 5. It is going to be slightly variable unless or unlike the agonist where almost everything is going to be synchronized as a cohort. After you start the HMG or recombinant FSH, so let's say on day 4, day 5, day 6, day 7, day 8. Let's say you administered 5 shots of HMG, then usually people call the patients back for an ultrasound where they try to assess the size of the lead follicle. Is it 12, 13, 14 millimeters? And then they decide on addition of antagonist. So usually this is done, okay? Usually it is done that when the lead follicle is around 12 to 14 millimeters, for practical purposes, you might add an antagonist. Okay, antagonist could be needed for maybe 2 or 3 days. All right. We believe that for practical purposes, it is very good to follow something called as a fixed protocol. That means irrespective of the size of the lead antagonist, you should have a fixed dosage day of antagonist. Okay, we typically like to keep it on the 6th day or the 5th day of stimulation of HMG or recombinant FSH, where we would like to do a fixed protocol with antagonist. That allows, absolutely nullifies any risk of developing a premature LH surge. This is the standard. The advantage with antagonist is that it can be used for everyone. It can be used for poor responders. It can be used for hyper responders. It can be used in patients with severe PCOS. It can be used in normo responders. It can be used for everyone. The only addition which we do is that when we are using it for very poor responders, we like to give pre-treatment estradiol. Okay, we like to give a pre-treatment estradiol. The only thing which you should not give to patients on antagonist is a pre-treatment OCP. Okay, do not give this when you like to do an antagonist protocol, because a pre-treatment OCP will very severely reduce the LH levels. All right, that is something which you do not want to do. It is going to affect the oocyte quality, and when the LH levels goes down, it is going to reduce the number of top quality embryos which you are going to obtain out of antagonist. One small criticism is that when you use an antagonist protocol, the number of top quality embryos are lesser as compared to the agonist protocol, which may or may not be true. Okay, in our experience, we like to use both the protocols because we do a controlled stimulation on an individual manner for an individual patient. We are extremely happy with the antagonist protocol, but these are some practical things which you should remember. Finally, there is one more thing which you can do very nicely as far as the antagonist protocol is concerned, and that is the trigger. Okay, when you are using the antagonist protocol, it gives you the liberty to use 0.3 decapeptyl or agonist as your trigger. What happens is when you use the agonist trigger, there is very quick luteolysis. So this one, it drastically reduces OHSS rates, and second, it can be used when you are doing something called as dual stimulation. These are two great advantages of using the antagonist protocol. When you use the antagonist protocol, it's very important that as a clinician, you also follow up these oocytes. You also follow up how the stimulation has resulted into formation of blastocyst embryos. One small tip which we like to give here is that if the total number of follicles, antral follicle count is more than 15, okay, instead of giving a single trigger, we like to give a dual trigger. And the dual trigger would consist of giving agonist along with HCG. We have seen that that consistently gives you increased number of metaphase 2 oocytes, and it increases the number of your top quality embryos, especially when you are using the antagonist protocol. The other great advantage which it offers is that it offers you a lot of liberty. At our place, when we use the antagonist protocol, we almost always do a freeze-all strategy for all patients in whom we are using the antagonist protocol, and we think that is an extremely good protocol as far as ovarian stimulation for patients is concerned. Any further questions on this, you can put on the WhatsApp and we shall be very happy to answer. Thank you so much.